Jacoby is one of Australia's most acclaimed and awarded television producers and media executives. During her 40-year career, she's created and worked on some of our most popular and successful shows. Think Andrew Denton's Enough Rope, The Gruen Transfer and Sunday. And after years spent researching other people's stories, Anita began investigating her own family, and what she discovered was fascinating. She joins us now. Welcome to the show, Anita.
Hi. Hi. Thank you both for having me this morning.
It's a bit strange for you sitting on this side of the camera.
It is totally not my position to be sitting here. So I'm finding this... In fact, somebody just said to me, you used to work on Good Morning Australia years ago.
You did. Here at 10,
in the studio.
Yeah, I know. I'm
not here. At North Ride.
At North Ride, yeah.
Oh, welcome
home. With Kerri-Anne.
With Kerri-Anne and Gordon Elliott.
There you go. So back to your incredible story. You've discovered a heck of a lot about your very distinguished father.
Yes.
How much of a teaser do you want to give us?
Well, look, it's an extraordinary story. I know, Ange, we were just talking about it a moment ago. I have told hundreds and hundreds of stories all over the world with everybody from Clinton to Sir David Attenborough, you name them, you know, Angelina Jolie, only to discover that the most extraordinary story of all was actually long buried in my own family, which was a little bit kind of freaky. So it's all about escaping Nazi Germany after being jailed. It's about coming to Australia, a new country, at a time when the world was very different to as it is now. It's about espionage. It's about love life. I mean, my father was married 4 times, but that's this of his actual life. So
Wow. It's
been the most extraordinary journey for me. Because, you know, as a producer, you don't tell your own story, you tell everybody else's story.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. I was just saying, when I was reading this book, I thought if I was an editor and somebody presented this to me as fiction, I'd go, yes, probably just a few too many twists and turns. No one's going to buy this.
I know.
No one's going to buy this many twists and turns in one person's life. And
exactly.
That's your own dad.
Exactly.
You know, some of it's quite confronting. How hard was it for you to write about these things?
Enormously hard. Mm. I really wrestled with writing about it because originally I started to tell a family story. It was going to be just for the family. But the more that I dug and the more that I found out in this incredible story, the more I felt compelled as a journalist to tell the story. So I was wrestling always about being a daughter and then being a journalist, because we journalists don't tell our stories. We go to dinner parties and we tell everybody else's story, but we never tell our own. And so it took me many years to actually sit down and think, I've got to inject some of my story in here and I've got to tell it. Because I think it speaks to Australian history, it speaks to who and what we are, it speaks to relationships, marriages, but most importantly, it speaks to the fact that kids never really know their parents.
So true. Because,
never.
I mean, you discovered things at a dinner party. Somebody told you a
exactly.
secret about your father at a dinner party and you went, well, hello, what?
Exactly. I was at a dinner party full of journalists and lawyers. We were talking about a triple murder case here in Sydney, and one of the lawyers stopped and he paused and he said, do you know about the infamous court case in the 1950s involving your father? And I'm like, what court case? You know, every bone in my body as a journalist, but also as a daughter, was so intrigued. And then I found out it involved an Olympian who'd won double gold, who had actually ridden horses for the Queen, who'd given a horse to the Queen. I mean, he was one of Australia's top sportsmen of his day, and he was the polar opposite of my educated, cultured, Germanic father. So I was off and running. I just couldn't help myself.
How did the family react to you putting that story down?
Look, I took them every step of the journey, because they know that originally I set out to tell the family and our story just within the family. But I discovered so much more. And actually, you know what it's done? It's made us closer. Because we suddenly realise all those elements that shape you, that influence you, now become apparent because your parents are so influential. Like, Ange, I know your mum and I know that you're very much, you know, you have a very close relationship. Parents are so influential in who and what we are. Mm. And I guess what I have this great regret, I can never ask him all these things that I've found because he's long gone.
Yeah. It's your own career. So, you know, working with Andrew Denton on Enough Rope, with John Laws on his interview series in 60 Minutes. You were one of the first females to break through the all-male executive
rank. Only just by
tenacity and pushing. You have a lot of stories to tell, interviewing Bill Clinton, lining up interviews with Elton John, with all of these people. And they're woven throughout the book as well. In a very clever way.
Mind you, it's not an autobiography.
No,
it's very much a memoir.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah.
But lots of stories haven't been told out of our industry.
But you do tell some interesting things about the history of television too, because you have been a woman in a very pivotal time in Aussie TV.
I came up through breakfast television, and of course, first of all, was GMA here at 10. And then I ended out on the Today Show, which is obviously the brekkie show today. And in those days, it was hosted by Liz Hayes and George Negus. And I was the 2IC, the supervising producer. And not once, not twice, but three times, I put my hand up to be the executive producer. And each time I was passed over for a male, because in those days they didn't have females running shows. Mm. The highest you could get was to be 2IC. They had women in publicity and PR, and they had women occasionally in programming, but not on news, not on current affairs, not on general programming, not on sport. We didn't get a look in that pivotal role of running a show.
And it was your dad who said, back yourself. So you walked in, you quit, and then got the gig at 60 Minutes.
Exactly. I quit Today's Show. I walked in and saw the head of news and current affairs. He couldn't believe it that I would walk in and resign. Well, my dad said to me, you know, if you feel confident in yourself and you know you can do the job, then, you know... And it was at a time where it was fairly easy to get another job. So I just went in and resigned. And you're right, I got a job on 60 Minutes, which was then the biggest show in Australian television. So it really paid off for me to take that risk.
Yeah. It's fascinating to hear all these stories, and your own is the one that tops the lot, as you say.
Yeah.
It's an incredible book. It is... available now,
it's
and it's
available.
Called Secrets from Beyond the Screen.
There it is.
And I reckon you should get your hands on it pretty quick.
And I haven't told you, like, most of the story.
I know, because it's a tease.
In there.
It's a tease.
Yeah, it is a tease. Thank
but,
you.
Yeah, thanks so much for being with us today, Anita.
Thank you both very much.
It's Anita. Like what you're seeing? Why not subscribe? And if you'd like to see more like this, over here.